Before Doctor Strange's Multiverse of Madness, before Spider-Man No Way Home, before Rick and Morty? There was the one. Well, actually, the idea of parallel universes has been around for a while. Hugh Everett originally proposed the idea in 1957, but it was popularized in the 70s by Bryce DeWitt, who actually came up with the name Many Worlds. Since then, the concept's been featured in all kinds of things, from comic books to television. But for me, and a lot of other 90s kids who grew up watching crazy action movies from the early 2000s, the one starring Jet Li was the first time I'd really heard of the multiverse, or Many Worlds theory. At least, it was the first time I heard it articulated in such a concise way. Most of the time parallel universes come up in the media, it's an evil version of the protagonist in another universe, like the Star Trek original series episode Mirror Mirror, which featured the infamous goatee Spock. Another more classic display of the alternate universe is by the protagonist stepping into another dimension. This is why many people consider Wizard of Oz to be the first alternate universe movie. But Jet Li's The One was the first time I saw the concept of multiple realities that really focused on the idea of infinite versions of you with subtle or drastic differences in these alternate worlds. The movie starts with Jet Li playing an inmate who's escorted out of her prison and killed by Jet Li. Later, the exact same sequence plays out, except this time Jet Li isn't the inmate, but a police officer named Gabe Law. He's the protagonist of the film. These are actually great sequences that set up the differences between universes. One of the subtle ways they do this is the news playing on the TV in the background. In the first universe, they mention President Al Gore, while in Gabe Law's universe, it's George Bush. It's a cool detail that's easy to miss, but it showcases the subtle yet impactful differences in the multiverse. After Yu Law, the evil Jet Li, kills the prisoner, he gets captured by two multiverse agents. See, this is where the movie sort of fails. Although the overall concept of the multiverse is explained fairly well, the details are pretty fuzzy. Let me break down all the information the movie gives us. So, there are 124 universes, which I'm not really sure why there's only 124. I mean, the original concept of many worlds is that there are hypothetically infinite universes. Anyway, the multiverse is monitored by the Multiverse Authority in the Universe Alpha. This world has gained the technology to travel between worlds, but it's strictly prohibited, which is where the agents come into play. Yu Law is attempting to kill every version of himself because, and this is where the movie takes some liberties, every time an alternate version of himself is killed, the power is distributed to the remaining versions. This whole idea was just made up to make the movie more badass, I think, but what can I say, it kind of works.
After this, there will be only one.
Once it gets down to the last two Jet Lis, Yu Law and Gabe Law, they basically have superpowers, which makes for some really cool action sequences. And yeah, some of the effects have aged a little bit, but you can't tell me you don't get jazzed when you see Jet Li start dropping bodies and Drowning Pool comes in. I mean, take me back to 2001, please. I'll be honest, I'm probably going to get copyright claim for that, but I mean, come on, give me a Monster energy drink, a flat brim Punisher cap, and a skateboard I don't know how to ride. I'm all in, baby! There's actually a couple sequences like this that'll make anyone who experienced the early 2000s smile, because it just captures that time period so well. The story's really straightforward from here, it's just Yu Law trying to kill Gabe, and a lot of action in between. Gabe's wife plays an important role and adds some emotional depth to the film. There's also an interesting dilemma of Gabe's police buddies thinking he's gone crazy after seeing him shoot up a hospital room. Of course, it's actually Yu Law they saw, and now Gabe has to try to convince them it wasn't him, to no avail, of course. The two multiverse agents, Rodecker and Funch, have an interesting dynamic because Rodecker was former partners with Yu Law before he killed himself for the first time. This gives him a little sympathy for Yu Law.
You miss me? I missed who you were.
Meanwhile, Funch is newer to the agency and is a little more risky. All these things add together to make the movie very fast-paced, and it really flies by, which makes it an easy watch. It seems like they can create wormholes in the Universe Alpha, but they don't really get into the details of that. Like, it seems like they only have a certain period of time they can do it in, and they have to wait a while before they can do it again.
Only had a 30-second window. Now we have to wait.
It's all really vague and the rules seem completely arbitrary, but for an 87-minute runtime and a focus on the action, I can forgive them a little bit for not having time for the more technical sci-fi details. So, I'm not going to spoil the whole movie here. I think that there's a few twists that are actually unexpected and kind of cool, and the ending of the movie, I mean, it's one of the most rad endings I've seen in one of these early 2000s action films, so I think you gotta watch it for yourself. So yeah, it's not the first piece of fiction to introduce the multiverse. Hell, Sliders portrayed a lot of similar concepts, and that came out 1 year before. Although it was more based on branching timelines, even Back to the Future toyed with the idea of a parallel universe. The One isn't a mind-blowing sci-fi film or a completely accurate representation of the multiverse hypothesis. Honestly, it's not even a great film. But as a kid who loved kung fu movies, it still managed to be my introduction to the idea of alternate universes, and that's a subject I've remained fascinated by to this day. So, if you're a fan of martial arts films, sci-fi, or just a sucker for cheesy action movies, check out The One, you'll probably have a good time. Also, I would love to see The One remade with the science fiction more fleshed out, maybe a less cheesy tone. That could be cool. Anyway, I know I don't usually do film reviews, and don't worry, I'll be back to the creepy stuff next week, but either way, thanks for listening to my brain droppings on the subject. If you have any recommendations for obscure television shows or films on the topic of the multiverse, let me know in the comments, I'd love to check them out. And subscribe if you like my gray face. But as always, this is Grief speaking. Goodbye, friends.